Hello guys, what is up? My name is Dishank and welcome back to my channel. So guys, today I bring you alternatives to all the Nvidia Broadcaster offerings. Because the software requires RTX cards, so it is not possible all the gamers or streamers around the world to get the help of Nvidia Broadcaster to stream quality content. So I have managed to found all the alternatives which are similar and very effective, and it will help you out in streaming. So without wasting any more time, let's get started with the video. Okay, so step first, you have to download OBS. For that, just type on Google OBS Studio and then download from here. Okay, after downloading OBS Studio, install it. I probably assume you all know how to install a software. And after that, go to type RAID0 plugin. This plugin will work on your microphone so that you don't pick up any background noises, and it will be just like an AI microphone alternative of Nvidia Broadcaster, and I am using it right now and I will show you a sample after I show you how to download and install. All you need to do is download it and then press next. Nothing any special, and make sure to figure out your architecture of your computer. If you are rating a later system, it's definitely going to be 64 bit. If you are using a 10 year old system, 8 year old system, then you need to check if it's 64 bit or 32 bit. Otherwise, only download 64 bit. After this, you need to go to Google or just type on your URL bar XSplit VCAM, and then click on your the first link and then download this VCAM. I have already downloaded, so I'm not showing how to download or how to do the installation process because it's pretty much straightforward. So after you have all the files you need and installed those, go to your OBS. So this is how the OBS looks like. So first of all, I will show you how to do the microphone. Select your default microphone. After selecting your microphone, then go to filters. After going to filters, press on the plus icon and then VST plugin. When you click on VST plugin, then select, first of all you have to select the RAID0 standalone. Click on the standalone, then open plugin interface. When you are going to open plugin interface, it will show you something like this. Then you have to go to mode and then select subtract. What will it do? It will going to remove all the background noise from your environment. Like I'm going to show you live that when I will click on this automatically build noise profile, it will start to reduce all the ambient noise in my room so that it won't get picked up when it's complete. You probably heard some. I'm also speaking. But in this process, you have to do when you click on my microphone, you have to stay silent so that it won't pick up your noise. And if it picks up your noise, it will also cancel out after. So you have silent in this process. You have to just wait for 5 seconds. I think it's pretty much it. So you probably heard when I clicked on automatically build profile, this thing, when I clicked on this, so it started with zero and then it moves towards almost eliminating all the background noise. So this is how the AI thing they are promoting, marketing, is working actually. So they have not invented anything unique. This is much pretty much it. It is basically, we have to do two things here. Like, we have to come install the plugin and then click on the automatically build profile. They are doing with just one tick. So that's the thing they have built or they are marketing upon, so that people buy RTX cards. Don't fall for that. After this, so this is for another safe side. After you click on add plugin, then go here, pick up a plugin, and then use regate. This is basically a noise gate. So when your first plugin is working, let it go down. Okay. So basically you have to go here and then find a perfect spot where it doesn't go above that. So this is the perfect spot. When I'm not talking, it is staying below that point. So okay, so this is basically what it's going to do. It won't clip the voices, and whenever I'm not talking, it will go to zero. So this is the microphone setup, and now for the webcam, all you need to do is open webcam. This is how webcam going to look like. Let me just turn off this because it is going to pick only one microphone at a time. So this is your webcam, right? So basically, how this software works, there's nothing special. Just you need to open it and it will pick up your microphone. Very simple. And if you want to remove your remove background for your streaming purpose, just click here, remove, and it will remove everything around your body. And it has another feature, like if you want to stick with chairs also, I think, yeah. So it is also picking up my chair, right? So there is a little bit more options, but I don't think it will be necessary for everyone. Just go with default. After this, you just make sure you never open this application again, because once you set it up, you never need it again. Just minimize it and forget it that it is on your system. But it is for the initial setup I'm teaching you. Then go to your webcam and then click on Exploit Webcam. This is how simple it is. Then press activate. Oh no, we have to create. Okay. We have to create new source. Create a new source. Go to video capture. Type webcam so that you remember it is a virtual cam. Then click on Exploit Webcam. See, it picked up, right? This is how simple it is. And you know, I'm not using any green screen behind me, and this is as accurate as Nvidia Broadcaster, trust me. And you can see the quality of the webcam, and you can also check out my streams, which I do. I'm using Xsplit webcam only, and this microphone Reaper setup. So how to remove this webcam overlay? Just crop yourself and frame yourself a little, and then just bring it wherever you need on your videos. This is how it is done, simple as that. So I hope you learned a few things, and I'm probably sure now you are not compelled to buy an RTX card if you were looking to buy RTX card only just to stream in better quality. So RTX card is going to help in encoding 10-15%, but the price to, if you are looking to buy a new card, it is very expensive. So I will probably suggest you to stick with whichever is affordable to you and use this setup, because it's going to be a waste of your money if you are probably just looking for the streaming purpose, right? Even if for gaming, like if you're getting a card for 5,000, 10,000 rupees, why you're going to waste 50,000 for a new card, which is just going to perform like 20-30% of the previous card. If you have the money, go for it. Otherwise, just stick with this, which I have just taught you. So thank you for watching, guys. It's been a 10 minutes video and I don't want to stretch it anymore. So thank you for watching and see you later.